a minute and we're gonna get set up here and looking on our Nailympia page. So give us about a 30 second delay here and we will be right with you because we've got an exciting presentation going. There we go, let me click on that so we can see ourselves on the iPad and on the phone. So I think we're ready.
Okay.
All right. So it's Karen here from Nailympia Canada once again, and I am super thrilled to be here with Cheryl Thibault. Cheryl is the director of Mirage Spa Education, and Mirage Spa Education is one of our sponsors here at Nailympia. So we thought we'd pop on real quick on live and learn a little bit more about Mirage Spa and what you have to offer there. And I'm laughing because all of a sudden I'm looking at that camera and that camera. We got multiple angles going here, so you get all of us.
I'll just look at you. How about that?
So hi and welcome. We're very excited that you signed on to be a sponsor with Nailympia, and we hear so many good things about your offering of an online nail education and aesthetics. So tell me more about what you have to offer and what is Mirage Spa?
Huge. Anyway, Mirage Spa is our online platform. We were brick and mortar until I think 2009. We had so much interest in the online that we closed the school itself and went completely online. So for the nail portion, we actually use a training hand, and you do the nails on the training hand, and the little fingertips are all different sizes. You can push them in for a flatter nail, have a higher arch. You can pull them longer for an extension, push them back for a nail biter. So you get a lot of different choices. And we get you to do them on the training hand. They all come off and they're mailed into the office. And we have a girl there who, a wonderful lady, Susan. She's been with us forever. She actually took our course in 2002, so she's been with us a long time. And she does all the student assessments, makes a video, and sends the nails back to the students for correcting and rebuilding so that they know now how to do a refill. So there's six different modules in the nail course. The first one is just gluing on tips, shaping, blending, learning the basics of that. The second is the gel. The third is liquid and powder. And then the fourth, they get an e-file. So they have to learn how to use e-file and not do the cuticle area. Be careful there. And then the fifth is a fun program. It's nail art. Oh. So that's fun. Yeah. And in that, we actually offer gel and acrylic nail art, as well as decals and rhinestones. So it's a fun module. And the sixth is our manicure pedicure. And in that, they actually do models. So they have to do a human. They can't just do a plastic foot.
Yeah.
So all the kit is included with all of our modules. They each get a separate kit. So it's all comes as one big package. And we've expanded across Canada. So that's nice that we can teach from BC all the way to Newfoundland.
Yeah.
We have students, even internationally, we have some in Chile and the Bahamas and internationally too, so.
So what's nice about it is once the students complete we are kind of multitasking, so I love that you are all commenting. We will get back to your comments probably after the live is finished. We'll jump back on and answer some of your comments to that. So please comment away and we will respond to them after. But what I was going to say is I really like the idea that not only are they they're taking their course and they're learning, but they're mailing it in. Someone's looking at them. It's not just photo based,
right?
Which is, I think, really helpful. It sounds like they're going to get some really good feedback every time that they send their tip in, and they get, you know, you can see a lot more when you physically see it than when you get a photo of it. So that's a really interesting aspect.
And they can keep the video,
right?
So when they have that section and they go to do another nail, they can always resort back to, oh, what did I do wrong at that time? It's sometimes even better than being with an actual instructor, because the actual instructor will tell you something and you're thinking, oh, I'm hungry. Oh, I gotta go for, and you don't even sometimes hear the constructive criticism they're giving you. Whereas when you have a video to resort back to forever, you can always better yourself in that regard too. So I think it's a lot better. And the other thing that I know from experience in the school itself, is when you have a model come in, they don't always want to sit there for 5 hours.
Very true.
That's really difficult because you'll get one hand prepped and they need the washroom. And it happens all the time. Or, you know, they're texting now on their phone or they're fidgeting or, you know, everything happens. So you're stressed. You've got to get them out because they don't want to go home with one hand done. They want them both done.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of the stress of actually working the first few times on a model that is taken away.
Yeah.
So you learn how to hold the hand and how to maneuver and, you know, hold the file so you're not worried about cutting them or anything like that with your file. So all of that is behind you. So when it comes time to actually hold a pair of hands and work on a person, all that stress is pretty much gone. I mean, there'll still be some, but not like before. And your time frame has gone from 5 hours down to maybe two.
Yeah.
So it really, we've had, just in what I see in my students, it's just been a better way of training, actually, than even hands-on has been.
So when you talk about the modules, then somebody who would be interested in becoming a certified nail tech would do all of the modules as a grouping?
The course is based on 400 hours.
Okay.
So that's what we taught in the school, was a 400-hour course, and that was full-time. So now, because most of our students are distance, they're not in a city where they can actually go to school. They're new moms that don't want to go back to work. They're women in transition of a job who still has to stay full-time employed and can't afford the time to go to school. They can do it in the evenings. They can do it in weekends. I actually had one student who was an airline attendant, and she'd take her hand with her, and when she was in an airport or a hotel, she would do her work from there. So it just opened up the whole country to different training. So they can take it at any time, anywhere, and it just, I forgot what your whole question was. I just got carried away there.
No, that's great. I think it's a really great option, and especially here when we're talking Saskatchewan and rural Saskatchewan, is that it's not actually always possible to come in to some of the bigger cities and be one-on-one with an educator or attend a class in person. So speaking from the rural perspective.
Right, you are rural.
I am rural, yes. I'm on a farm.
Been city, you know? But,
it's a great option because, you know, we don't always live close to a center where there is a place that we can attend in person. So this is a really great option for those that are interested in becoming a certified nail tech, that they can go online and do it that way with a really solid structure of education. I think when I've looked at it as an overview, it's very well thought out and structured. Other than certified nail tech, are there other things that you offer through Mirage Spa?
Yes, I just want to backtrack
sure.
for 1 second if I can. I just want to say one of the challenges we had starting was because it is online, people didn't think we were credible.
Right.
And so we really had to fight. I'm getting emotional. I do that all the time.
Oh, that's fine.
Anyways, we really had to fight to make our mark, pretty much, you know. Oh my gosh, Karen, look at me.
It shows the passion that you have for your school. Like it's touching to know you care so deeply about education and helping women and men become certified nail techs is a real passion for you. So
it is.
It's good to be emotional about it.
Well, it's to my heart, obviously. It's true to my heart. But anyway, back on that, is we did have to really, I don't want to use the word fight because it wasn't a fight. We had to prove ourselves, you know, that we were a legitimate registered trade school. And we do have registration certificates with the Department of Education in BC. So we're not just an online class that you can YouTube us and you know, walk out with a certificate. That's not what we're about. We really take pride in what we do. And we really want our students to go out knowing with confidence that they can actually do the job, you know. What I was saying before I got carried away a while ago is when you have a model for 5 hours, sometimes if you miss a class in school, you can't get to make that up. You miss it.
Yeah.
And if you need to do, you know, four models in a course of your whole course, that's sometimes all you get. Where with us, you do 50 sets of nails. It's not, it's not like four little things and you're certified. It's a lot of work. So it's not just a fly-by-night little course that you have to take. We actually make sure that you are good before you graduate.
Yeah.
And if you need to redo it, we make you redo it. So it's not just, oh, she sent it in, let's correct it and get it off. No, we make you redo it. And you have to be of, you know, your standard before you get the diploma. So
shout out to some former Mirage Spa education students. Yeah, I know there's a couple. I see Twyla Martin and I think she's a former.
She's a grad.
Grad of Mirage Spa. So
she's rural too.
Yes,
she's country, and she's done really well. She's really excelled in nail art. She's got her own little Instagram and Facebook and stuff going.
Oh, great. So if you're watching in your former Mirage Spa, tag yourselves and follow along and introduce yourselves to us. We'd love to keep following everyone that you're having come through the school. It sounds really great. And so you are based in BC?
Yeah. We are based in BC, but we do teach across Canada.
Yeah.
The other courses that we offer. Right. So the smaller version of the nail tech course we call just the artificial nail tech, and it does not teach manicure and pedicure. So it's only artificial nails, and that's based on 200 hours.
Okay.
So 200 is artificial, and then 200 is natural nail with a manicure pedicure to be fully qualified. And now we've advanced into, we now do aesthetics and spa therapy, but we don't do practical with that. They are taught on video and through the textbook, exams online, and then we ask them to go and apprentice in a salon.
Okay.
So that they can get their hands on training in a salon, because they're all over Canada. They can't come to me and well, they can if they want. It's a nice place to come to.
But it's warmer than here, I bet.
So then they would get their certification in theory, and then they would take that and go to a salon or spa and apprentice until they felt comfortable doing that.
That's great.
The work themselves, yeah.
So where can we find you?
I'm right here.
Yeah, right here in Saskatoon. Here. It's not as warm as home, but
it used to be close to home.
It used to be
China girl.
That's right.
So we're at the W's, miragespa.ca is our school, and that's the website. So you can go on there and just under courses, there's a drop down and all the courses are there, and it gives an explanation of pretty much everything that we do.
And then I know we follow you on Facebook and Instagram, so you can check that out as well and find some updates and get the links to your website, and encourage anyone that's considering becoming a certified nail tech and you're not able to attend in person, this is a really great option for everyone to look into as well.
Thanks.
So,
Now
we have you here for Nailympia, so we're throwing you in to the Nailympia world. So it's our first year here in Canada, and so we've reached out to some great industry experts, and of course education directors like yourself are a perfect fit to come and help us judge for Nailympia Canada. So it's really exciting to have
you
here.
I'm excited. I mean, it's Saskatchewan in the winter. What else would you want? But Nailympia, it's the first time in Canada, so Karen is the founder, is that right?
Well, Igul and I, so Igul Fritzky, she would be here, but she's teaching a class right now. We got together just a little less than a year ago and decided that it's time to really bring this to the Canadian nail industry, because we have a lot to offer here in Canada.
We do.
And the Canadian nail industry is always growing, and we have a lot of talent and a lot of nail artists that have responded and are coming, and we also have a really good international group coming as well. So we just really wanted Canada to shine and to show the world that
there's so much talent
so
in
much
Canada,
here.
So much hidden talent that, you know, nobody sees, you know, because that's great that it's here, because we've always had to go America, London, where else is Nailympia?
Nailympia, London, Estonia, US, and Canada.
Yeah.
So four locations.
Here's Canada.
Yeah.
But I'm honored, actually, to even be in the room with you guys. So that's, it's great for me.
Yeah, no, you've been a really wonderful support. As soon when we contacted you, you reached out right away and jumped on board without hesitation.
Oh, I guess.
Yeah, I know. So no, it's exciting. Great. So great. We are looking forward to tomorrow. We'll give them a little bit of an overview. So tomorrow, here at the Saskatoon Inn, competitions, I believe, start bright and early. Competitors set up earlier than
and we're on BC time, so it's really early.
So if you are thinking, if you're a nail tech and you want to see what the competition's all about, we encourage you to pop by the Saskatoon Inn. We will have a viewing area open. We just ask that if you do come, to be respectful of the competitors' need to concentrate and to have quiet in the room. And then we ask that you don't do any posting on social media in the competition room, because we don't want that to be shown across social media, to keep judging confidential until the end. That's fine, but during the day we ask that you don't post anything to social media, close up of the competitors competing. We just want to give them their space and their time.
Well, they're stressed.
To do their competitions.
And a lot of them are on, not just me with 2 hours, but they've got some 12, 18 hour gaps of time.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's some jet lag and you need to focus.
Yeah. So it's please come and watch, but just remember, we'll give you lots of reminders about just quietly observing. Mm-hmm. And as well, you're going to be participating in the Nail Talk Night.
Yes.
So that's Saturday night. That's going to be
Another hot seat.
So Saturday night here at the Saskatoon Inn again, starting at 6:45, we're hosting. I was looking at that camera. I didn't look at this one now. At the Saskatoon Inn here, starting at 6:45 on Saturday evening, we're hosting a Nail Talk Night. It's a chance to come meet and greet all the judges, including Cheryl. We'll be there. We'll mingle. We'll have some time to visit. And then starting at 7:30, we're going to have an informal just chat, question and answer. Elaine Watson will be there moderating the conversation. Mm-hmm. And it's a chance for us to talk nails. We can talk about nails for hours.
Funny, isn't
it? I know. You just put us all in a room.
Who would think? In fact, when I've told people in BC about Nailympia, because most people had never heard of it, and they're like, you have competitions for nails? Like, yeah, we do. Yes. Well, what do you compete in? You know, so maybe say, do you want to just say what some of the categories are?
Oh, yes. Yeah, we have 11 categories, and they range from your classic pink and whites. We do have a competition style pink and white, which is not an everyday pink and white. There's some very strict guidelines and measurements for that one. We also have salon, which is replicating what would happen in a salon. You have 60 minutes to do one hand of beautiful French pink and white salon quality nails. And this year it is including a feature nail design. So they get to add one design to one of the nails. As well, we have the stiletto competition, which is a fan favorite. We have Joy of Nails with bling. So, you know, that's
always fun.
My favorite. And then we also have some art competitions as well, reality nail art. And then the biggest fan favorite, I think, is fantasy.
Yeah.
So on Sunday, the fantasy competition is the last one of the day. It's full look, costume, and nail design. So that one's always a fun one.
And awards.
Following that. So just come on over to the Saskatoon Inn this weekend. We'd love to see you. Come say hi. Find Cheryl, say hi. Find me, say hi.
I'll look like this.
Maybe like a little bit more grab bags on your head. Yeah, no, everything's coming together and we're super happy. So we won't keep you much longer. We just wanted to touch base with Cheryl and learn a little bit more about Mirage Spa Education.
Thank you.
And we're very thrilled to have you as a sponsor. So we'll see everyone here and there and there. And my iPad's going too. So we will see you here around Nailympia all weekend. So pop on by and say hi.
Yeah.
Thanks again.
Brave the cold.
Yeah,
it's
brave the cold.
Not that bad,
yeah,
is it? It's not that bad.
It isn't that bad.
It's doable. It's completely doable.
And the sun will be out tomorrow, so it'll be a beautiful day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not that we'll see the sun all day, because we'll be inside. But all right,
we
take care, everyone.
Shines in Saskatchewan.
Yeah, it does.
It does. Yeah.
All right,
anyway,
we'll see everyone
thanks
later.
Watching.
Thanks for watching, and we'll get to your comments.
Just want to say our email address.
Please
I
do
say
yes.
So, if you have any questions and you do want to connect with us, our email address is education@miragespa.ca. So it's pretty easy.
Yeah, perfect.
To find. So yeah, you'll find us there.
Great.
Okay, thank you.
Bye. We'll see you. I'm going to do this one first, and then I'm going to pop over that one. So bear with us for 2 seconds. Bye-bye.